Hello and welcome to our second CHCH Virtual Assembly. I am Christian Shemankovich from the class of 2021. We have a lot of fun things in this week's assembly. Let's kick it off with Dr. Conrad.
All right, Charger Nation, welcome to week two of Virtual Assembly. We may not have school right now, but as you can see, I continue to get schooled every day by my kids in basketball. I wanted to welcome you to the second week and introduce you to my pet. This is our family pet, a Russian tortoise named Pebbles. Pebbles is only 3 years old, and what's so charming about Pebbles is that Pebbles should be living until 75 years of age. Charger Nation, have a great week. Thank you, and enjoy the virtual assembly.
It's time to celebrate CHCH birthdays with help from the Daniels family. This week in Mr. Spencer's class, they had a birthday celebration of their own.
Happy birthday, dear Eric. Happy birthday to you.
Eric. Oh, thank you.
Make a wish. Make a wish and blow out the candle. There, you did it.
Yeah.
Dylan from the class of 2020 has an inspirational quote to share as a part of the Senior Legacy Project.
What's good, class of 2020? You already know I miss all of y'all. And I wish I was with all y'all right now in classes. But you know, with this whole coronavirus thing, we all gotta be safe, stay at home. So make sure we're all doing that. But my inspirational quote that I wanna share with you guys is, no storm lasts forever. I really like this one because for me, it kind of means that like, even if you're going through something hard right now, it's not going to last forever. And at the end of the day, you're going to get through it.
In New England, signs of springs are showing up everywhere. And the CHCH community has been enjoying it in many different ways.
Okay. Hi, Aiden. Aiden, can you say hello? Hi, we're outside enjoying the sun and blowing bubbles. Aiden, can you blow bubbles? Yay! Get outside and enjoy the sun. Aiden, can you say bye? Bye!
Help! Wanna make a triangle?
No! I didn't find it.
What's that?
Hi everyone, Miss Shipley here, and I thought I'd tell you about some signs of spring.
Does anyone know what those are? That is the call of the spring peeper, a small frog found in eastern United States. So if you have any water near your house, go out anytime near dusk and see if you can hear them too. Enjoy.
It's week two of distance learning at CHCH, and here are some tips to help everyone keep improving.
Oh, hey, Chargers. Didn't see you there. It's Mr. McPhail here with a couple of tips for working from home. Tip one is create your own space, right? It's important to have somewhere you can put your stuff, you can stay organized, you can keep all of your work in one place. Tip two is to set some times for work. All right, it's really easy to get lost when you're working from home because home becomes work, work becomes home. So try to set a few hours a day outside of school to get your homework done and make sure that you know kind of when and where those are going to be. Number three is prioritize. So if you have a couple of different assignments due tomorrow, pick the one that's due first, do that one. It's the same as it would be for regular school. And the last one is communicate. Make sure, especially now that you can't see your teachers every day in person, that you're reaching out, that you're asking questions, that you're using those office hours, because that's really going to help you out. And other than that, stay colorful. Enjoy spring.
Mr. Anderchow here with your tech tip of the week. Utilize your Zoom contacts to easily connect with anyone at CHCH.
Ashley.
Yes.
Are you doing your work?
Yes, I am. Let me close out the five different tabs that I have going on right now, like Facebook and Pinterest and Macy's. Nobody needs anything at Macy's right now. We're not going anywhere. Here with your SAS tip of the week, I am one that struggles with procrastination significantly. And part of the issue is I have five different things going on at once. And so I really suggest to my students to make sure that they close out all of their distractions. The cell phone actually should be away. The television should be off. I actually should be sitting up in a better position, probably at a table, and trying to focus on the task at hand. One of the biggest things that we find to be really helpful is working for 20 minutes at a time, getting up, giving yourself a break. Please give that a whirl this week, and I hope everyone's doing well.
Here is your health and wellness tip of the week.
Hey everyone, Ms. Weber here with your wellness tip of the week. Now that everyone has kind of been self-quarantined and staying indoors, kind of laying low, I want to make sure you're choosing 3 days a week for 30 minutes. Get that heart rate going. Find maybe 5 or 6 songs that you love, put them together in a playlist, and get moving. It helps the endorphins flow, it helps reduce that cortisone, and you'll just feel better. Doesn't have to be anything special. No one can really go to a gym right now. We've been lucky with some sunny days here in New England. Go for a walk. But even if not, be creative. Find some wall push-ups to do. For me, being almost 8 months pregnant, stairs do the trick. They get me out of breath. So I got my weights, I got my yoga mat, and I'm about to hit play on my playlist. Get going. It'll feel good. Enjoy.
That's a great tip. Now, CHCH teachers, can you show us how you've kept active at home?
Hi, this is Corey following the wellness tip of the week. Grab my dog, grab my 5-year-old, and I chase them. Ready? Go.
Hey CHCH, it's Mr. Boucher. If you know me, you'll know how much I hate sitting, so I want to show you my standing desk setup today and what that allows you to do.
Check it out. You do not need to buy a fancy standing desk. I found some stuff around the house so I could get my computer screen at my eye height. Got my mouse, my microphone, set my iPad up so that I can write while I'm on Zoom. I've also got drawers full of what I need down here. Keep my water and tea close. And I've got a sitting set up next door, so if I need to sit down, take a little breather, I can.
Since I got my standing desk, meetings where I'm on mute have never been more fun. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically I'm saying either way we about to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Don't forget to keep dancing.
Hello, Chapel Hill, Chauncey Hall. It's Miss K. So if you know me, you know that I love rock climbing and bouldering, and those things are really important to me. And that's a big motivator in why I exercise and work out. So I've been trying to figure out how to stay strong so that when I can go back to rock climbing, I'm still able to do all of the fun climbs that I used to be able to do. So this summer, I was not able to do a pull-up at all. And so I've been working on getting my pull-ups, and now I add weight to them. You may think I'm crazy, but I have tied an 8-pound dumbbell to my waist so that I weigh more, so that I challenge my muscles more, and they have to adapt to be stronger. Everyone in my class should know about phenotypic plasticity. This is a great example of how it works. Okay, here we go. So I like to do 5 sets of 5 weighted pull-ups because that is what research has found to be the most effective at making stronger muscles. So now you know what I've been trying to accomplish in the farmhouse without you all. I miss you. I can't wait to see you next year. Goodbye.
Gabe from the class of 2021 has shared a poem with us.
Ooh, creepy. Hey, it's Gabe from the class of 21, and I have a poem to share. It's called Cemetery Moss, Etc. Under gnarled oak I sit alone, among the brambled vines all overgrown. Buried bones decay and turn to soil, They once had names, now carved in stoic stone. Polished gravestones shine like holy oil, or sweating foreheads of mortician's moil. His and my relief is shade, the leaves, and nets of vine that tangle, grasp, and coil. I watch as beavers swim and flowers grieve, despite the way that nature's so naive. My faith lies in a wilting yellow rose. It isn't God, but earth that I believe. Moss and lichen creep and cling and grow on marbled granite markers lined in rows. As long as swamps can sink and wind can blow, death can find new life in dirt below. Thank you.
All right, CHCH community, it's time for your announcements and shares.
Hey guys, it's Maria from Class of 2023, and I just want to come on here and make an announcement to any musical theater kids or anyone who's interested that you can actually watch some shows and performances from your home. They're all found on Broadway HD, which I think is a 7-day free trial, Netflix, YouTube, Prime Video, and also Disney Plus. So if you have any questions on any of what musicals are found on there, feel free to email me at mgriffin23@chch.org. I'll respond as soon as I can, and I hope you really enjoy some of the musicals.
Hello everyone. On behalf of the math department, I wanted to share one way that you can use math in these very trying times to avoid negativity, and that is to use the absolute value function. F of x equals the absolute value of x. What that does is it helps you stay positive. Watch how this works. If you take F of frowny face and you put it into the absolute value function, frowny face, what comes out is a smiley face. Thanks everyone and be safe.
Hi friends, do you want to hear a fun fact? So I learned that walruses can whistle. Yep, that is a true thing that walruses do. So.
Hey.
Here are some walruses whistling. And now you know.
Hi, Charger softball fans, it's Miss McDonald. We wanted to keep our softball season alive, and we thought we would do it current ESPN style by sharing highlights of seasons past. So, did you know at this time last year it was opening week for Charger softball? Here are some of the single game highlights. Michaela Murdoch pitched a shutout, striking out 5. Layla Cavero went 2-for-2 with 2 home runs. Sydney Duell went 4-for-5 with 2 home runs. Denisa and Meg scored 4 runs apiece, and Mint scored the first run of her career. We also want to take time every week to share some fun facts and honor our seniors. So for example, did you know that Mint had never played softball before she got to Chapel Hill? Yet she batted .417 last season when we were undefeated. And Michaela, did you know that she is a 2-time IGC League MVP and a 2-time Boston Globe All-Scholastic selection? Well, now you do. We're going to keep honoring our seniors every week, so stay tuned.
Good morning. My plan for today is to make Italian wedding soup. Nothing better on a rainy day than some homemade soup. So you got to start with making the meatballs for the Italian wedding soup. So I'm taking about 2 pounds of hamburger, or ground beef, excuse me, a couple of eggs. I do all this in my KitchenAid mixer. Makes life easy. I don't have fresh parsley, but I have this little container of parsley, so I'll throw that all in there. I'm not gonna measure, but about 1/2 cup of Parmesan cheese, depending on how you like it. To me, that adds the most flavor to meatballs.
We have a very special performance to end today's virtual assembly, and it's one that you might not expect. Here is Miss Cook performing an original parody song about distance learning at CHCH to the tune of Taylor Swift's The Best Day.
Hey everyone, it's Mrs. Cook. One quirky thing about my family is that we are often taking the lyrics to songs and mixing them up to fit our lives. And I've had the song in my head for the past couple days and thought I'd share it with you. So here's Taylor Swift's The Best Day, Chapel Hill/Zoom edition.